Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I am making a moringa leaves burrito, which is a very healthy and satisfying burrito. So I hope you will enjoy today's recipe. So here I have taken pre-cut and washed moringa leaves. So I'm making a puree of these moringa leaves, and you can, if you don't have moringa leaves, you can also use spinach or any green leafy vegetables that you want to use. You just have to make a puree and keep it aside. And then I have taken 2 cups of wheat flour. To this I'm adding approximately 1/2 cup of oats flour, and to this I will be adding some flaxseed powder. This is approximately 2 teaspoons of flaxseed powder. And then I'm adding our usual spices like salt, coriander powder, red chili powder, and carom seeds or ajwain. So I will add our spices, and then I'm also grating 1 carrot to increase the roughage of the dough. So moringa leaves are actually very high in iron, so it can make you constipated. So in order to remove that, I'm actually trying to incorporate as much roughage as I could. So that's why I have added oats flour and carrot into the dough. And now I will just make a soft dough of this batter, and then I'm also applying a little bit of ghee to make it really soft and to clean the pan. Now I will knead the dough and keep it aside. And now here you can see that I'm taking small balls of the dough, and I will be rolling it with a rolling pin. And I have already kept my tawa on heat. My tawa should be mediumly hot when I will place this, and then I will make basically paratha as we usually do. And the way I make my rotis is that I will make a batch of 3 or 4, and then I will try to cook them at the same time when the tawa is ready. So now here you can see that I'm rolling 2 moringa leaves rotis, and I will just keep it aside then. Next, after rolling a couple of chapatis, I'm actually gonna crisp them on both sides, or cook them from both sides, and then I will apply a little bit of oil and cook it as we cook paratha. And whenever you're cooking a chapati, make sure you flip it when you can see that the top side is substantially, it looks cooked, then you can flip your paratha. And then I have cooked the one side, applied oil and flipped it. Then I have applied oil on the second side, and then I will flip it again, and I will repeat this process for a couple of more chapatis. And once I have a batch, then I will show you how this could be assembled. Okay, now let's come to the assembly part. So here I'm taking my paratha, and then I'm applying cream cheese on top of it. You can use any cream cheese of your liking. I had Amul cheese at hand, so I'm applying the Amul cream cheese here. And this is actually really good for kids too. So if you want to give your kids a burrito with cream cheese and moringa leaf paratha, that is totally good. My daughter completely loved this. But for us, I'm applying some pickled radishes and onion, and some normal onions and some bell peppers. And I'm also topping it with some sriracha sauce. Basically, actually, you can add anything that you like inside this burrito and just roll it, and your tasty yummy burrito would be ready to cherish. And I can't tell you how good this was. I was just planning to eat 1 or 2, but I eventually ate 3, so you can totally tell that I really really love this one. So please try this, and you can add your ingredients inside, whatever you like. Basically, you can even top it with paneer or any kind of vegetables. I had some leftover pickled onions, so I'm adding that, but you can use basically anything. So here you go guys, your simple moringa leaves burrito is ready to be cherished, and I can't tell you how quick and easy it was to make. And I actually did everything in 1/2 hour, so I'm sure you would be able to do it in less time too. Please do try this recipe and let me know how you liked it. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more recipes like this. I will see you back in the next video pretty soon. Bye bye. Take care.